Hey guys, welcome to another Game Explained discussion. I'm your host, Andre Seegers, and this time we're joined by Derek Brainer and Colin McIsaac from Gamnesia to discuss the latest Nintendo NX news. So, let's get started. Alright guys, so there was a new report this morning from the Wall Street Journal that unveiled a few new details about the Nintendo NX. Now, nothing earth-shattering, but there's some interesting stuff here. And the big news here is that Nintendo is now starting to send out dev kits for the NX, which means developers can now start putting together games, hopefully in preparation for launch of the NX, whenever that might be. We'll get into that shortly. Now, on top of this, they also, the report also discussed that it sounds increasingly likely that there will be some kind of handheld aspect to this new system. They specifically say it will include at least one mobile unit that can either be used in conjunction with a console or taking on the road for separate use. And then they also add that the system will make use of industry-leading chips in the NX devices, after criticism that the Wii U's capabilities didn't match those of their competitors. So, so a few tidbits there. It's a little bit interesting. So I figured we'd just launch into our opening thoughts real quick.
If they can pull this off and maintain, like, get a basically a console that's finally up to snuff with the PlayStation 4 and the Xbox 360, which has always been a major complaint from people, is that it just doesn't look as good as the others, even though some games prove that wrong, and be able to actually get ports of all these cross-platform games. Like, they're always talking about cross-platform games, but they never come to the Wii U because it's so much more difficult to get it onto that system. So being able to keep up with the other two systems would be huge. Plus, if they are able to pull off this handheld slash console idea, whatever it might end up being, it would still continue Nintendo's unique the uniqueness amongst all the console developers, especially with, because this would be kind of huge, honestly, if they could pull it off.
And I think Iwata did say that they wanted to do something unique with the next system as well, like some unique aspect to it.
Yeah, for sure. What they did confirm is that it's a new platform with a, quote, brand new concept behind it. So, you know, obviously this would be a brand new concept, even if it's been sort of rumored in the industry for quite some time. What I'm concerned about is what they need is not just a console that has ports of games from other systems, because, you know, people already have those other systems. They're not going to come buy an NX so that it can play games on a different controller. Mm-hmm. What Nintendo really needs is sort of a couple different pillars to get people to buy this thing. That is number one. Number two is obviously their incredible first-party games, and they need to really hit that hard. You know, they can't do Mario Tennis Ultra Smash, reveal four characters up through a month before launch, and then say, hey, come by us.
Colin, I think hitting hard is exactly what you do in Mario Tennis Ultra Smash.
Okay, well, yeah, and the difficult thing is, you know, if they're trying to do this home console and handheld hybrid, if they're going to try to work the technology of the handheld into the home console, like, that's going to make a hugely expensive portable unit, unless they've got some really creative sort of, like, maybe they could do some, like, cloud streaming thing. You know, I don't know what kinds of inventive things they might be planning. We all know Nintendo's insanely creative. but at least in terms of the technology that I can think of, you know, if this handheld device is going to sort of try to be a portable companion to the NX, it's going to have to be crazy expensive if it's going to compete with, like, PlayStation 4 and Xbox One and stuff, which I think it sounds like we all agree that it needs to.
Yeah, I mean, they've had hardware parity before with the GameCube, and that didn't help then, so...
What do you mean?
As in, the GameCube was almost as powerful, or, like, you know, was in the same ballpark as
PS2. Oh, for sure, yeah, for sure.
So, yeah, I don't know, I mean, well, so that's actually one thing I was wondering, right? Because they do mention industry-leading chips in this article, but that doesn't necessarily mean extremely powerful, although they do kind of suggest that within the article by saying, after criticism, that the Wii U's capabilities didn't match that of their competitors. But I wonder how much of that is just editorializing on the part of the writer. Because, I mean, it's possible to have industry-leading chips that aren't that powerful. They could have, like, low-power, like, laptop chips, for instance, or mobile chips.
Yeah, it's really hard to tell.
I think it's going to be at least in the ballpark of the PS4 because Square Enix said that Dragon Quest XI could come to the NX, and it's already coming to the PS4/3DS. So if it's going to be able to handle Dragon Quest XI, which is a gorgeous looking game already, it's going to have to be, you know, in that same ballpark as PS4.
Unless it's a part of the 3DS one.
Yeah, I was going to say, they could do sort of an upgrade thing.
I kind
of
doubt that.
Yeah. I doubt too. I mean, I do feel like they I mean, if I had to choose it, they probably are shooting more powerful, but I think with Nintendo, you never know for sure. They could pull a Wii and repackage a slightly upgraded Wii U hardware in a brand new form factor.
Yeah, they've been talking a lot about making the Wii U forwards compatible with basically their ecosystem in the future, and I'm hoping that doesn't mean that it's basically just going to be a two Wii U's duct taped together, because the biggest issue I think for Nintendo right now is their third party support, and that's not, you know, a lot of people seem to think it's a matter of third parties, you know, are biased against Nintendo, but no, the real reason that third party support is so barren on Wii U is because it has a radically different system architecture than the other platforms, which means they can't just port it from one of those systems to the Wii U. They have to do a lot of really serious coding work to get it to function on Wii U. What they need to do is encourage third parties to port their games, and the way to do that is to make the system structurally similar, even if it's not necessarily competing on a power level.
That is a good point. That, I mean, one of Nintendo's big issues is lack of third-party support, and that partially isn't due to the fact that the system is harder to develop for. Although, I mean, you know, it primarily is the fact that the Wii U just didn't sell anything. And
well, yeah, that goes into it. It's like, you know, they see the low install base and the amount of work and money that they would need to pour into developing a port, you know, means that
it's not worth it,
with
right.
a low install base, yeah, it's just so much less lucrative. They're all making their own business decisions. This is bad business.
So it would make sense for Nintendo to streamline that as much as possible, or to make it as easy as possible for developers to port games over. And, you know, the timing kind of works out, because Nintendo is actually making a much more powerful system. So, like, let's say they just want to have parity with a PS4 and Xbox One. Luckily for Nintendo, those two consoles actually went with, like, a lower spec this generation than they typically had before. Like, they used relatively cheap components, and didn't go nearly as, like, cutting edge as they have, like, with the previous generation. Which means it would cost Nintendo comparatively little to catch up to them in terms of hardware power. Especially given the fact that the NX wouldn't be launching until, at the soonest, 3 years after the systems had come out. Which makes it even cheaper to catch up to them hardware-wise. But if Nintendo really is going, like, you know, cutting edge with, like, graphic capabilities, maybe they'll even surpass them. Like, maybe that's something they're trying to do. Like, maybe what if this is maybe not the best analogy, actually. Or maybe it is the best analogy. Like, this could be Nintendo's Dreamcast, right? Where it basically, you know, leapfrogs the current systems in a mid-generation cycle.
I don't know that their version of a Dreamcast is what Nintendo needs right now.
Well, I mean, I think it's
we've had enough comparisons of them to Sega.
What they want is Sega's ideal for the Dreamcast, not the actual end result.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, it's possible. I think a lot of where they're going to find the sort of cut costs in the technology is we've seen like patent surfacing of, for example, the system that doesn't use an optical drive and instead uses game cards, which, you know, optical drives are expensive and they take more power to keep the disc spinning. So that could be a really interesting way to see them sort of cut back on the cost of producing the hardware so that they're able to get the specs up to snuff. And, you know, we'll see what those kinds of patents that we've been seeing lately actually turn into in an end result. But
that is a good one, because that would be, I mean, because that would actually have multiple benefits. So they did ditch the drive, it'd be way cheaper. It cut down on the size of the system drastically, which cut down on the weight and shipping costs. That would just shave a lot of cost off in general for them, I believe.
Yeah,
so.
And you know, we're also seeing a lot about them going with multiple SKUs in addition to sort of the home console and handheld components. So, you know, one might be digital only, one might use the game cards, one might, maybe you could buy the handheld platform separate from the home console component. I don't know about that one.
I don't think the game card slot would even add that much expense for them. I mean, especially if they're ditching the drive. So, I think we would get a uniform system worldwide.
Okay.
Yeah. No, I think another question they're raised by this is that an analyst in an article mentioned that he thinks it's looking increasingly likely that the NX will launch in 2016. And that's been, you know, that's been, I think, a lot of people's thoughts, including my own. I thought, you know, I was under the impression that they would be aiming for a 2016 release because the Wii U, I mean, basically is a failure. And they want to, you know, they want to move on to the next thing as soon as possible. However, I was looking into this. So this is, according to this report, this is basically the first wave of dev kits. And I was curious about how that compared to the first wave of dev kits for the Wii U. And so I went back, and this is actually pretty hard to look to find articles. Anyways, I found an article from April of 2011 with a report from Edge Online that said that that did say that dev kits were just going out then. So at that point, that was a year and a half before the Wii U came out. And they even mentioned that in the article, the system could launch by the end of 2012, and they nailed it. That's when the system did come out. At this point, if this system comes out at the same point as the Wii U did, being November of next year, this is only about a year before the system's release. And that's even less time than the Wii U had, and we already saw how content-starved the Wii U was a launch. So, what do you guys think? Do you think they're still aiming for 2016? Do you think that's possible?
Yeah, or? I think they are. I think they can't really wait any longer than that. Like you said, Wii U is just a total bomb in the market. GameCube was already considered an embarrassing commercial failure, and as great as GameCube was, you know, that's just a fact in the industry. And Wii U's only sold half that much in the same amount of time, so that's really bad.
Yeah.
And, you know, 3DS is great, but that's aging. Sales are insanely slow these days. So, you know, they really can't avoid a 2016 launch. Holding it off longer is just going to be a huge shot in the foot. I think what they're doing, we've been talking about, like, a lot of sort of third-party ports. I think that's sort of what they're hoping for with these dev kits, is that people will be able to port their games a lot faster and more reliably. Now that their system architecture hopefully is a lot closer to the other sort of platforms. And then I think that they're going to fill out, or at least I should hope that they're going to fill out their software lineup with Nintendo games. Maybe a lot of them being cross-platform, maybe some of them being exclusive, but I think Zelda U is a huge candidate for that. I think Pikmin 4 is a huge candidate. So, you know, we'll see. Obviously, it would be great to have, like, Galaxy 3 or Metroid Prime 4, but I don't think either of those are happening. Mm-hmm. I think they're really going to try to do really strong, high-quality first-party content. And I think that's why we're seeing a lot of stuff like Mario and Luigi Paper Jam and Mario Tennis and coming out now and not really hearing much about their big, big projects, which they're really keeping under wraps, like Zelda.
The fact that they're only now sending out dev units to other developers doesn't mean Nintendo hasn't already been working on these games themselves.
That's true.
And there's all, you know, I have a feeling that they've been working on the process and sort of optimizing the process of maybe transferring up the, you know, Zelda Wii U to maybe Zelda NX, and whether or not it actually have a port on the Wii U as well as the NX, we don't know for sure, but if Nintendo is pushing a lot of these projects just to the NX, since they think they're going to hedge their bets on that, since the Wii U has already proven to be, you know, not as successful as they would like, it makes sense to just, like, we could be looking at a launch window with some truly excellent games that come out in that time frame. As Colin said, we, you know, Zelda. They might even push Star Fox back that far. They might, you know, the Pikmin 4, maybe the new Metroid game, because we haven't heard anything about Retro working on anything. And if they could get these big titles ready for the NX, and just, like, maybe not all at launch, but within the next 6 months of its after its release, and then have the and that would give enough time for third-party developers to step in and offer up their own content. It could be a very successful launch. Now, whether or not that will happen, it's impossible to say. It's sort of a pie-in-the-sky look at things, like things are going to work out perfectly. And Nintendo's always had a little bit of difficulty with system launches, so we'll see how it all ends up. But if they've learned from their mistakes and have been working towards that, NX could have a very good launch, and I think everything sort of falls into place for that.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we've talked in length in previous NX discussions about our feelings on a dual handheld console development thing. It's a big question I have. I mean, you talked about multiple SKUs, Colin. Do you think they'll release both in a bundle and try to keep it the cost down? Or do you think they'll be separate? Or how do you think they're going to try to package it?
I have no idea.
Because the way this Wall Street Journal makes it sound, it sounds like it's like
going to be
two different devices. Yeah.
Yeah, I sort of read it as it was going to be two different devices that were bought in the same package. But, you know, obviously they're going to want to try to keep the costs down. And
yeah.
It would make sense to sell them separately. But then, you know, we'll get into a PlayStation Vita situation. And, like, you know, I don't know. It's just, it's going to be really difficult for them to figure out how to actually get this thing out. If they can figure out how to overcome those sort of marketing obstacles, I think they have huge opportunity here. But, you know, the exact same thing could have been said for Wii U, and obviously they did not overcome those marketing obstacles.
That's the thing, right? Like, if they sell it as a packaged unit, it sounds like... I think it might be perceived as just a better Wii U. Let's say they give you a console and a handheld they can take with you anywhere. I mean, that is potentially cool, and maybe they will market that right. But I feel like that already has been... Like, the Wii U has already kind of ruined the brand value, or the... you know, the value of that idea, I think.
Yeah, I mean, I think we'll also have to see a lot of how Tatsumi Kimishima plays into this, because I think he's got a ton of... I mean, you know, he was the CEO of Nintendo of America for a long time. He was a huge marketing guy in NOA back during the sort of Game Boy Advance, GameCube era, when their... I mean, I suppose their sales weren't that great, but their commercials certainly were, and he was the guy behind the whole We Would Like to Play push, which is obviously worked really... really great wonders. So, you know, I think we'll sort of have to see how his guidance and insight into these kinds of situations is going to help them manage their launch. We already know, I'm sure you talked about this earlier, he already said, like, guys, Wii U's a terrible idea, no one's going to understand what this is.
Yep.
And, you know, Wii U has great software, but yeah, nobody understands what it is except for Nintendo fans, and so that's you know, he's got a lot of insight, and we haven't really met him yet, but their first investor meeting with him at the helm is coming up in just a couple days, actually. There have been rumblings of a new Nintendo Direct coming, and I'm sure they'll sort of, you know, I doubt he'll host it, but I'm sure that he'll make some sort of appearance, and Bill Trinan will say, hey, here's our new president. So, you know, I think we'll just have to wait and see how he comes into play, because he's going to be a huge factor in this. Excuse me. Because he's going to be a huge factor in this, but, you know, we just don't know enough about him yet. We haven't seen him for ourselves.
Yeah, I mean, it's going to be definitely a marketing challenge no matter what. I mean, just given how the Wii U's happened. But I'm still thinking about, like, what they're going to do just hardware-wise. And I'm inclined to think that maybe they'll... I don't think they'll go the Wii U route again. I think it would be too costly for them. It might be... I mean, I don't know. I'm thinking, though, what they'll do is they'll have... a console, you know, a console-like system, and then there might be maybe multiple, like, handheld-type devices you can then sync to it or connect with.
Yeah.
So maybe, like, a smaller 3DS-like handheld, or, like, a phone-like handheld, or a tablet-like handheld. Like, I don't think they'll include, or if they do include one, maybe it'd be a small one, but I feel like they'll have different form factors or something. I don't know. I feel like they're doing something different. And that might actually explain why the system, if you go off those patents, might be getting a cartridge slot. Because what if you could actually use the same game on multiple platforms? So, like, take Smash Brothers on Wii U and 3DS. What if that actually were on the same disc, or same cartridge, rather, and you could plug that in and get a different experience? If you plug into the NX home console, you get the full, like, HD experience, whereas if you plug into a smaller 3DS-like device, you would get a weaker but still comparative experience.
I certainly think that's true. They actually opened up a new development website recently for developers to sort of register and get working on Nintendo's platforms. And one of the platforms that they list is, it basically says, a new platform. And in that area, they sort of say, you know, you can decide which platform you want to develop for, and then which SKU you want to develop for. And so... I don't think that necessarily means, like, it's going to be radically different development. It does hint that they are looking at putting out different SKUs, like maybe a phone-like component, or maybe a 3DS-like component, maybe a tablet-like component, that all work with the NX, but belong to the same family, but aren't themselves the same device.
Exactly. There's, like, multiple ways of accessing the same or similar content. Like, and they all work together in a uniform way.
Yeah, and tailor that more to individual consumers' interests rather than trying to mash everything together in some sort of thing that Well, like the gamepad, for example. It's fantastic. I love the gamepad. But because it mashes everything together, nobody outside of Nintendo's ecosystem really understands what it even is.
Right.
So.
Yep. All right. Well, do you guys have any final thoughts at all? Anything else you want to touch on before we wrap it up here?
Yeah, nothing too major. But, I mean, if things go well, this could be a major upswing for Nintendo. I mean, it could continue the downward swing that they've unfortunately mm-hmm. been having. But I'm optimistic about this whole thing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, me too. I am hoping and thinking that what they're gonna do is sort of tie this into like their mobile plans. You know, we see Pokemon Go has a $30 million budget. Like, that's huge. And they're also talking a lot about like doing movies or TV series and stuff out of their franchises, adapting their franchises into sort of multimedia and get people back into the Nintendo gaming ecosystem by exposing their brands to larger, different kinds of media audiences. And I think if they really launch that whole sort of, and the Universal theme park, of course. So if they really launch this whole sort of all-encompassing cultural sort of explosion, if they time that nicely with NX, I think that they could do a really good job coming back on top.
Yeah, I'm optimistic too. I mean, I actually do think Nintendo might have learned some lessons this time.
And, yeah, me too.
It sounds like, I mean, Iwata did set them on a... I mean, it sounds like everything he was saying in the past year, like, sounded good. It sounded like the right thing they should be doing.
Absolutely. So it was very cryptic, but very positive.
Yeah, definitely cryptic. So, I mean, I guess, it could be interpreted any number of ways. So,
yeah.
But no, I'm excited to see what they do here. And Nintendo did say that we will be finding out more about the system next year. Possibly, I mean, they didn't say, but I'm guessing possibly before E3. Much like how we heard about the Wii U, or the original Wii before E3.
Yeah.
So hopefully, maybe something will be the case. I mean, and if it is in fact launching next year, I almost feel like that will have to be the case. We'll have to hear about it before E3.
Yeah,
E3 will be the big, you know, unveiling of like all their games and whatnot. And man, if they pull that off, like if they condense the launch of a system into a single year, like they'd be riding the hype train all the way to the launch.
Yeah, so, I mean, that's gonna be a huge project. I really hope they can pull that off.
That's a question. We'll see.
They just need a good name.
Yeah.
Oh God.
Alright, well, I think that about wraps up for us here. So, Colin, do you want to tell everyone where they can find you at?
Yeah, you can find me at Gamnesia.com. You can also find me at Gamnesia TV, our YouTube channel, where we post a lot of, like, Nintendo news and discussions and stuff about, like, the Twilight Princess HD thing. We're wondering if that's actually sort of experimentation for Zelda Wii U, the way Wind Waker HD was. So we've got some interesting stuff over there you can check out.
Awesome. And of course, if you guys liked our discussion, make sure to like and follow us on Facebook and Twitter at Game Explained. You can find links to them in the description below, which go away to keep up to date on everything we post. And of course, keep an eye on Game Explained for more on the NX and other things gaming as well. All right, thanks, guys. Bye.